Foreign direct investments have a major role to play in the economic development of any country, as they serve as a launching pad for increased capital. Countries with a healthy investment environment also see increased infrastructural, technological, and other improvements in the country. On this episode of Government in Action, we examine Guyana's efforts to become a nation which is poised for investments so that the country can continue along its path of becoming a sustainable economy. One of the cornerstones of a healthy and robust economy is the creation and maintenance of a thriving business environment where entrepreneurs can prosper. This administration has, over the past 2 years, vigorously worked to create a safer and cleaner destination for investment, while at the same time improving the quality of local products and services to achieve greater competitiveness in the higher earning segments of the global market. As part of achieving this vision, the Ministry of Business in 2015 launched a 5-year strategic plan aimed at improving the ease of doing business, attracting increased foreign investment, supporting the development and export of value-added industries, increased economic opportunities for and capabilities of vulnerable groups, and increased capacity to develop and promote sustainable business-friendly policies. Since then, Guyana has improved by 16 places on the World Bank's Doing Business Index. This was the largest single improvement achieved in the country's history of being in the index. Moreover, for the year 2016, Guyana's total investments, including foreign direct investments, facilitated by the Guyana Office for Investment, was $114.8 billion, moving from $89.3 billion in 2015. To continue along this trajectory, government must ensure that the legal, infrastructural, and other important types of framework of the country are at internationally accepted standards. Efforts must also be made in ensuring that foreign investors are made aware of these developments. In that regard, it becomes an utmost priority that ambassadors and high commissioners be in the forefront, finding markets for Guyana's products and seeking out foreign direct investment opportunities. President Granger has said that a very active foreign service is needed as the country depends on the work of its foreign missions to promote tourism, trade, investment, and other interests.
As far as the country is concerned, when we speak of the national interest, we mean that the diplomats or foreign service officers must go out to the places where they are stationed and sell rice, sell rum, sell timber, sell Guyana as a tourist destination, bring in investors.
The importance of encouraging investments was one of the core messages highlighted in April at Guyana's Heads of Missions Conference, a convention which brought together Guyana's diplomatic representatives stationed in countries across the world. Minister of Foreign Affairs Mr. Kyle Greenidge said that Guyana has the obligation to strengthen the work of its missions in the pursuit of economic diplomacy, within which includes attracting investments.
It may also mean that we will have to think in terms of expanding our representation in areas where this could lead to greater economic exchanges, or examine existing relations to see whether they can yield greater investments and economic dividends. Also, in putting economic diplomacy at the service of traditional diplomatic methods, we will be looking to the Guyanese diaspora as an area that can also contribute to this exercise.
The role of the foreign missions aside, government has also continued in its foreign engagements to strengthen bilateral relationships and to increase the interests of foreign investors to Guyana. Most recently, President David Granger made his first official visit to the United Kingdom, where several of his engagements promoted Guyana as a healthy destination for investors. Among those engagements was an investment seminar on Guyana hosted by the Caribbean Council. The event saw the attendance of several UK stakeholders, including oil companies and other agencies. At the investment seminar, President Granger said that the administration is working to improve Guyana's reputation as an attractive investment destination, particularly with regard to the legal and regulatory environment that will ensure the ease of doing business for foreign companies investing in Guyana.
We can assure you that your profits can be repatriated. We can assure you that our legal system, our judiciary, our ombudsman, our Auditor General, our elections are all entirely in consonance with what is required in Western Europe and the Commonwealth. Only last year we had our local government election, which under the previous administration had been suspended for nearly 2 decades. And when the elections were held, we created 3 new towns so that the urbanization of our hinterland is proceeding apace.
During an interview on the sidelines of that visit, the president said that Guyana's future as an investment capital is promising, particularly given government's efforts to create a conducive environment for business and commerce.
I think now they're seeing greater transparency, they're seeing a respect for institutions, they're seeing passage of legislation for anti-money laundering, they're seeing the arrest of persons who've been accused of former government servants who've been accused of committing offenses. I think they feel that Guyana is a safer, cleaner destination for the investment. And when people plan to come into a country, they would want to do reconnaissance, they'd want to come and do feasibility studies. And I think this is what is taking place now.
The theme of investment rang through the duration of the president's visit and was reiterated during his meetings with the diaspora and staff of the Guyana High Commission in London. The president highlighted that one of the main roles of foreign missions is to engage investors and other stakeholders and encourage them to invest in Guyana. Speaking to the members of the diaspora, the president said that they can play a major role in plugging their own capital and knowledge into the economy of their homeland. The president's view of the pertinent role of the diaspora in contributing to the investment thrust is not limited to the UK, however. This message has been made to members of the diaspora during other official visits, including his most recent trip to the Bahamas in March earlier this year. There, the president urged the diaspora to invest in Guyana, particularly in areas of green tourism, education, and information and communication technology. The president has said that Guyana is a country with an abundant amount of natural resources, adding that Guyana's tourism potential is a source of wealth in itself. He stated, however, that investments are needed in order to convert that wealth into a good quality of life for citizens. Moreover, the country's future as a petroleum-producing state certainly places it in a pivotal position where foreign countries will now look to tap into the opportunities that will undoubtedly be created in the near future. During the 2017 budget presentation, Minister of Finance, Mr. Winston Jordan, said that with the right amount of investment and technical expertise, Guyana can become a regional oil and gas services hub, which would create a substantial number of skilled and semi-skilled employment opportunities for our people. However, these efforts to secure foreign direct investments have not gone without the acknowledgement of a series of difficulties facing the country, particularly in the area of infrastructural development. President Granger has said that government is focused on comprehensive development plans that include deep water harbors, aerodromes, and road and bridge networks that link the coastland to the hinterland. As government continues to create an environment that is attractive to investments, Guyanese can be assured that these efforts are being made with the country's best interests at heart. In the near future, Guyana can become a land bursting with opportunities, a thriving hub in the Caribbean region where a good life is provided for every citizen. This is Jasmine Payne. Thank you for joining us.